Your swollen and stiff fingers might not be just from overuse or just because you are getting older. They could actually be the early signs of rheumatoid arthritis, an autoimmune disease where your immune system starts attacking your joints. And if it's not treated early, it can affect your heart, your lungs, and even your eyes. I'm Dr. Diana Girnita, and in the next 10 minutes, I will explain to you how rheumatoid arthritis begins, why is it so often missed, and the latest treatments so you can protect your joints before it's too late. Let's begin. Rheumatoid arthritis affects around 1% of the population, and many of these patients are women, often in their 30s or their 50s. But what is rheumatoid arthritis? Rheumatoid arthritis, or RA, is not just arthritis. It's an autoimmune disease. And that means that your immune system, which normally protects you, will turn against you and attack your own joints. But this attack will trigger chronic inflammation, which over time will destroy the cartilage, will erode the bones, and will cause permanent deformities. Who gets rheumatoid arthritis? Rheumatoid arthritis can affect anyone, but it's most common in women that are age 30 to 60. If someone in your family has rheumatoid arthritis, then that will double your risk or even will triple the risk. But genetics are not all. Smoking, hormonal changes, and certain infections like EBV, CMV, and even COVID can flip the immune system and can switch and trigger the disease. But how do we recognize the early signs of rheumatoid arthritis? At first, you may notice that your hands have some mild swelling of the fingers, your rings might feel tight, and your fingers don't close easily, and you cannot make a full fist in the morning. But then you realize it takes more than an hour to move them every day because of stiffness. You may feel very fatigued, and plus, you may experience low-grade fevers, loss of appetite, dry eyes, dry mouth, or tingling and numbness in both hands, which can resemble carpal tunnel syndrome. But if you have symmetric and bilateral symptoms in both hands, both wrists, both shoulders, both knees, and both ankles at the same time, this is most likely rheumatoid arthritis. Now, how do we make the diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis? As a rheumatologist with many years of experience, I can tell you that no patient is the same. So, to make a diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis, I need to listen closely to my patient's story, to see the sign, the symptoms, how did they evolve? And then I order labs and imaging like x-rays or ultrasound or even an MRI. The classic lab tests for rheumatoid arthritis are rheumatoid factor and anti-CCP antibodies. But now we have newer antibodies available, like anti-MCV or mutated citrullinated vimentin, or anti-carbamylated protein or anti-CARP, or anti-BRAF or anti-PAD4 antibodies. Also, important is to test for the ANA or the anti-nuclear antibodies because that will rule out other forms of autoimmune diseases like lupus. When it comes to imaging, ultrasound and MRIs can detect early inflammation way before x-rays will show any damage. But positive tests do not make the diagnosis, and that's confusing, correct? Your clinical story, your symptoms, and their pattern, along with the test, will make the diagnosis. Once you have a diagnosis, the correct diagnosis, then the next step is to start treatment. Starting treatment early can prevent those irreversible changes and will help patients achieve remission. The first step in treating rheumatoid arthritis is to control the symptoms. When patients come to me in pain, with their joints swollen, they want relief and they want that fast. So I can use NSAIDs like ibuprofen, naproxen, meloxicam, or celecoxib, which will ease their pain and stiffness. If NSAIDs are not effective, then steroids like prednisone or methylprednisolone are the magic drugs because they can calm the flare-ups and they can help you with pain, but they are not the long-term solution. If we use steroids in high doses for a long time, then many side effects such as weight gain, diabetes, and osteoporosis will be the main consequences that you might face. And then the next step is to stop the disease from progressing. And here we have a couple of options: DMARDs, or disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, then biologics or biosimilars, and small molecule drugs like JAK inhibitors. DMARDs, or disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs, these are the foundation of rheumatoid arthritis therapy. The most common ones include methotrexate, hydroxychloroquine, leflunomide, and sulfasalazine. In more severe cases, or for those patients where they don't respond to DMARDs, the next step is to use biologics or biosimilars. And these are usually monoclonal antibodies that will target specific molecules that are responsible to create inflammation in rheumatoid arthritis. And in our days, there are many classes of medication, but let me give you some examples. TNF-alpha inhibitors like etanercept or Enbrel, adalimumab or Humira, infliximab or Remicade, sertolizumab or Cimzia, golimumab or Simponi. And then we have IL-6 inhibitors like tocilizumab or sarilumab. We have T-cell modulators like abatacept or Orencia. And we also have B-cell targeted therapy like rituximab. They can be given alone or in combination with DMARDs, like hydroxychloroquine or methotrexate, but they are usually recommended after you fail DMARDs or the therapy with DMARDs is not enough to control your disease. What is confusing for many patients, including mine, is why these drugs aren't proposed first. Once again, many other doctors, including myself, we always balance the risk and the benefits. And when the time comes, I will talk to you about these drugs. Now, for those of you that have been on biologics for a while, you most likely heard that now insurance companies are proposing biosimilars instead of biologics. What are biosimilars? They are the generic versions of biologic drugs. They are supposed to work the same way, have the same safety profile, and offer you similar benefits, but are often available at lower cost. Something to mention is that all the biologics are injectables, self-injectable pens, or they come as an infusion or as an IV. And now let's move on and talk about the small molecules. Are they small? Are they small drugs? No, they are actually pills. And yes, you can actually take a pill that will be similar to a biologic in the same way that it will target certain molecules from your immune system to reduce inflammation and stop the progression of your disease. And the biggest players in rheumatoid arthritis are a class that we call JAK inhibitors. Medications like tofacitinib or Xeljanz, upadacitinib or Rinvoq, or baricitinib or Olumiant. But they are expensive, and they are hard to approve if you never tried or never failed other drugs like DMARDs or biologics or biosimilars, and they do come with some side effects. If you have a history of heart disease or blood clots, I would not advise my patients to take it. I am using all of these options with great success in my clinic, Rheumatologist on Call. But it is always an individualized and personalized plan for each of my patients. Not only that, but if you are watching my channel for a while, you know that I'm a great advocate of combining a holistic approach that will address heavily your diet, your exercise, your level of stress. And I also use certain supplements that are scientifically proven to help, because I'm a big believer in the Mediterranean lifestyle, and I often talk about it in many conferences and in my book, Thriving with Rheumatoid Arthritis. Read this book because it will clear the confusion regarding that holistic approach for patients with rheumatoid arthritis. And if you're still here, don't forget to subscribe to support my educational mission. And please leave me a comment about your journey with rheumatoid arthritis. Now, just a few comments about the future of rheumatoid arthritis treatment. Research is looking into new classes of medication to address other pathways of inflammation. Therapies that can reset your immune system, like CAR T cell therapy. But all of these therapies, there are still a long way until they will be approved or in use for everyone. One thing I want you to remember, do not believe in people who will promise you a complete cure. There is nothing like that. And they, unfortunately, lie to you. And if you need help with rheumatoid arthritis, my partners and myself are here to help you. Not only to thrive with rheumatoid arthritis, but also to have a better life. So you can book a consultation with us on rheumatologistoncall.com. And now that you learn a lot about rheumatoid arthritis in these 10 minutes, please learn even more about the foods that you need to avoid and that will cause a flare-up of your disease. And you can find all this information in this next video.